Okay, it's been a good solid week of practice and excited and ready to go. I hope everybody's excited for the home opener. I know our players will be. Good to be back home in our stadium. And we're looking to improve on last week and all the areas that we felt like we're not up to our standards. We played at a higher level. So we got the guys that really prepared very well, and we're concerned about us and how we play, and so hopefully we'll put that together here this week.
Questions?
Mark, did your kids have more of a case of jitters in some cases last week than you expected, or did you expect it?
Well, I don't know if I'd call it jitters. I would think, playing on the road against Southern Miss isn't as easy as some people might think it is, but those are some talented guys. They do a lot of they're very active on defense. In the first game of the year, you've heard me say it a whole bunch of times. I mean, you have a pretty good idea of what you have, but you never know what your football team looks like until you get that first game under your belt. So to go on the road and win, maybe you're not playing as good as you'd like in certain cases offensively, to be able to do what you have to do to win the game is most important. So I don't know if it was jitters, but I think we certainly need to build on certain aspects of offense, defense, and special teams. So I hope we're going to improve this week. I think we will. We've had a good week of practice.
How is Bungie? Do you expect to have him?
We do. He's a little gimpy, but hopefully he'll be able to play.
Mark, you said you said on your radio show you talked to Lynn about that issue, and after 5 minutes it was over. If he's given more opportunity this week, are you really looking for him to kind of step up and back up some of the stuff?
Well, I mean, we're just looking to get him involved, as again, like we had plans last week. I want to say we had him in the second series of the game. But again, like I told you last week, I didn't want to put him in the first time he was touching the ball. So we had planned to get him the ball soon after that, but it was just first downs that present itself, and it didn't happen. So any young player that we think is going to have an opportunity to contribute, we try to bring along. It's no different than Josh Pascal and guys that have contributed last week, and the young wideouts and all that. So he's no different. We'd like to get him involved. He's very talented. And each week, he's more and more comfortable. So hopefully, he'll get an opportunity to touch the football.
Other than Bunchy, I mean, did you guys have a pretty healthy week of practice? And is everyone kind
we
of
did. Out? Yeah, we did.
With Lonnie Johnson really not playing a football game for quite some time prior to Saturday, how did you think he played?
Not bad. He, he's got a ways to go. I'm hard on Lonnie because he has a lot of talent. And, we just got to, stay on him because he has the ability to be a very good football player. We got to get some bad habits out of him, and we're going to keep on staying on him, lean on him. But he's talented, so hopefully he'll get more and more accountable each and every practice and each and every game.
How important is it for the younger guys to get some experience in this game before you go on the road for your first SEC?
Well, we played whatever that number was last week, but a whole heck of a lot. I already went through that with my press conference last week, but what did I tell you? 23 or 24 guys on defense played, and quite a few on offense. So it was pretty important for us to play them in that first game. So we don't take anything for granted, like this all of a sudden is going to be real easy. But depth is always important, and building your team and building your program by getting reps in a game is always important. Whether we're playing Southern Miss on the road in a tight game or playing here.
Have you always wanted to play this many guys?
Of course. Yeah, of course. I think we saw some instances last year when we didn't play as good as we'd like down the stretch, and have guys fresh and healthy and is a big deal. You saw where it really helped us in our offensive line and developing the O-line, playing 9 guys last year. We're not as deep this year, so we got to do the same thing and bring those guys along. But defensively, it is very nice to finally have some depth, some guys we can count on to go in there, in particular on the defense and the front, to play and give us quality snaps.
So. Guys like Bohanna and Pascal and on offense, like Epps and those guys, they play their first game and they get that over with. What do you try to focus on with them after that, once they've got that out of the way?
It's always the details. And again, I used the word sledgehammer last week a lot, as you know, but we just hammer them with doing their job, because you never know how kids are going to react in a game, because guys that just kind of, you know, just revert back to bad habits and just playing ball. So young guys, it's always like that, especially when things start getting hairy. You know, you got to zero in on what you're supposed to do. You got to trust that your teammate's going to do his job and execute the way we teach him to. So it doesn't always happen, but I think the more and more experience you get, the better they are.
You said last week some of that stuff blew their mind, some of the wrinkles and so forth. Do you see a difference from one week to the other, or is it too soon? Do they have to get a few weeks into the
I don't think we've arrived by any stretch in any area. I think we're constantly going to be a work in progress, and I think we just want to build on the good things we did and, you know, try to stay away from, you know, some of the mistakes.
Everybody good? All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yep. See
you.